Millions of Americans have type 2 diabetes, about 1 in 10. And type 2 diabetes often develops in people who are over the age of 45. But something is happening due to our eating habits as more and more children, teens, and young adults are also developing this disease. And diabetes is a root cause of numerous serious health consequences, including blindness, kidney failure, and amputations, cutting off of your limbs, hands, and your feet. And you want to know how you can regulate your blood glucose if you have diabetes or you are pre-diabetic? Hi, I'm Dr. Omar Khan, a board-certified internal medicine physician, and I treat diabetes patients on a daily basis. And stay with me, I'm going to give you 10 food items that will naturally drop your blood sugar levels. And I will have a link in the description on a free detailed 4-week meal plan to actually cure your diabetes type 2 step-by-step once and for all. Now, the number one food item on my list is avocados. Avocados intake is linked with improved glucose control. That is a given to begin with. Avocado is one of my favorites because it has numerous health advantages, including naturally decreasing your blood sugar levels. It has high fiber content, low sugar content, and a high potassium content. Pairing your avocado with other foods help them reduce their sugar spikes. If a food has a high glycemic index, something that raises your sugar levels high quickly, then having avocados with those type of foods actually helps reduce those spikes and tries to normalize it. Then second are spices. Cinnamon and turmeric are two examples of spices, and cinnamon improves diabetes by enhancing insulin sensitivity and also helps improve your insulin secretion when it is needed. Cinnamon, we know, is a spice made from a tree bark, which is not surprising given that cinnamon's appearance, you know, it resembles a tree after all, right? Numerous studies have indicated that there is clinically relevant difference in your sugar levels when you take cinnamon. One study, for example, conducted on 69 patients in China, all of whom, of course, had diabetes type 2. And they compared those who used cinnamon on a daily basis and who did not. And they discovered that those who used cinnamon had not only lower sugar levels, but also a bad type of cholesterol called triglycerides. Then turmeric. Turmeric is a well-known spice. And if you ever tasted curry, you'll know that turmeric contains something called curcumin, which is responsible for the color and the flavor of the curry. Now, turmeric is a well-known antioxidant, a spice. It has anti-inflammatory properties. Now, third are fishes, especially fatty fish. So salmon, tuna, mackerel, shrimp are all examples of fish that you can have. These foods are low in calories. They help you maintain a healthy body weight, which is of course beneficial for diabetes control. It also prevents spiking of your blood sugar levels. They also have a lot of omega-3s. And when it comes to fish, fatty fish like salmon have also loads of vitamin D, potassium as we talked about earlier, as well as antioxidant characteristics. And according to several research papers, eating the right kinds of fish can help you not only drop your sugar levels naturally, but also stabilize, lower your triglycerides, and reduce inflammation. So whether you are a diabetic or have pre-diabetes, fish is a natural, fantastic way of reducing your diabetes. Then number four is non-starchy foods. Non-starchy vegetables, without doubt, are a natural technique to lower blood sugar levels. Now, carbohydrates is normally a string of glucose or sugar units in the form of long chains. And by eating lots of carbohydrates, particularly the starchy carbohydrates like bread, rice, and potatoes, so you know this, right? You can cause your body to absorb carbohydrates quickly, resulting in blood sugar spikes, which is not good for diabetes management. We know that. So with your vegetables, make sure to include a variety of non-starchy foods such as asparagus. I actually enjoy asparagus since it has a distinct flavor and it is high in folates and antioxidants, and it's also low in calories, so you can cook it in a different types of ways to satisfy your stomach without consuming a lot of extra calories. Another is broccoli. Broccoli is another non-starchy vegetable, and we all know the beneficial effects of broccoli it has on many things. It can also help lower blood sugar levels naturally by filling you up, bulking you up, and assisting you in losing weight. And not only that, broccoli is also high in vitamins and antioxidants, and it can help boost your immune system naturally. So non-starchy vegetables are another natural food item, natural technique to reduce your blood sugar levels. Then, oh my god, people forget about this. Next, number five is pumpkin. Pumpkin seeds have hypoglycemic, meaning glucose lowering, sugar lowering properties, and they could help you immensely in maintaining a good, decent sugar level control. Now, we know that pumpkin is low in calories and high in fiber. It also has a low glycemic load, which is not the same as what we normally talk about, the glycemic index. And whenever the glycemic load is less than 10, that is considered good. For pumpkins, the glycemic load is less than 3, all right? So that is good. But the problem is that its glycemic index could be a little high. So when it comes to pumpkin, it is critical to get all the health benefits, and that is by not having too much at once. So the glycemic index is a little high, but the glycemic load is low. So you can have this every now and then as a snack, but not like as a meal, like all of it together at once. Eating pumpkin in a reasonable amount is definitely very beneficial. And pumpkins also have abundant vitamin C, which of course aids in reducing inflammation in your blood vessels that can be harmed if you do have higher sugar levels. And then when I talk about pumpkin, I don't mean just any pumpkin. I am saying pumpkin that is fresh. So when it comes to making a pumpkin pie, for example, you already know that's not real pumpkin. That's a pie that has loads of sugar. If you're having pumpkin or any fruits, you need to have it fresh. Who knew that okra, you know, the good old okra, right? Okra has a chemical called Abelmoscus aequilinatus. This has a hypoglycemic impact, which means that it can lower your blood sugar levels. And when you eat okra, especially if you consume a lot of it, you can naturally aid to reduce your blood sugar levels. That's why if you're planning to add okra to your diet, or if you're already diabetic and on diabetic drugs, please discuss with your doctor, because it could have a powerful effect in lowering your blood sugar levels. Then number 7 are my favorites, nuts and seeds. Black seed is probably the best. Chia seeds are great. Walnuts, pistachios, almonds are examples of nuts and seeds. They are high in fiber and protein. So when you eat them, you will consume less calories. They can also fill you up and provide you with the sensation that your stomach is full, which means that you are going to be feeling fuller sooner. A study found that eating walnuts may be beneficial in decreasing your blood sugar levels, and they discovered that eating walnuts, which contains antioxidants, could reduce the chance of developing type 2 diabetes by up to half in some situations. Another benefit of nuts and seeds is that certain studies have indicated that they boost insulin sensitivity, meaning it makes your body use insulin better and thus lower and stabilize your blood sugar levels. Then another one of my favorite is beans, legumes, and lentils. They are low in calories, high in fiber and protein. Beans and lentils can naturally aid to reduce your blood sugar levels. They can also naturally stabilize cholesterol and help unblock your blood vessel arteries. Number 9, we are almost till the end. Sauerkraut. Sauerkraut literally means sour cabbage, and it is a German dish. Because it is a fermented cabbage, the fermentation process helps to keep microorganisms off of this sauerkraut, allowing it to be stored for longer than, you know, regular plain cabbage. Also, this fermentation is beneficial in other ways. For example, sauerkraut contains probiotics that aid in digestion. Sauerkraut is a low-calorie food, and half a cup serving of sauerkraut actually contains only 16 calories. And sauerkraut also has no carbs, no cholesterol, and it is high in fiber. And one serving of sauerkraut contains 2 grams of fiber, which is another natural way to reduce your blood sugar level. Now, one thing to be wary about when it comes to sauerkraut is that even though sauerkraut has all of these health benefits that I just talked about, it may be high in sodium. So one serving of sauerkraut does have around 200 milligrams of salt. And we all know that bad amount of salts in certain individuals can lead to blood pressure rising. So just be careful about that. Now, number 10, green leafy vegetables. I'm sure that you already know that. And when it comes to spinach, I am loving it. All of these foods, such as kale, collard greens, they're low in calories and high in vitamins, antioxidants, and beta carotenes. And bulking up with these meals will help you reduce the quantity of the bad foods you eat. So once again, there is no single bullet, but do you want to know a little secret? A lot of the items I've mentioned also have anti-inflammatory properties. And when you are dealing with chronic inflammation, it can increase your blood sugar levels. So doing activities to naturally reduce inflammation in your body can help you keep your blood sugar level stable and your blood vessels that cause heart attack also to calm down. So you see, guys, say goodbye to the misconception that your situation is hopeless. And I will have a link in the description with a detailed free 4-week meal plan. You can actually cure your diabetes over these 4 weeks. and loads of people have experienced significant reductions in their blood sugar readings, improved their energy levels, enhanced overall health, and have a renewed sense of control over their well-being. And you can check out this video where I talk more about tips and tricks to lower your sugar levels naturally in addition to improving your overall health. And I hope you find all of these suggestions useful today, but please remember to like this video and subscribe to the channel, press the notification bell, and share this information with your family and friends. Thank you so much. I'm Dr. Khan. Bye-bye.